Mandela once remarked, "For to be free is not merely to cast off one's chains, but to live in a way that respects and enhances the freedom of others." A very warm good morning to you all, Reverend Father Santosh Celestine, dear teachers, and all my dear friends. Today, we all are here to acknowledge our privilege to be born in a free India and to celebrate 75th Independence Day of our country. We need to ask those born before 1947 to know the pangs of anguish of being enslaved under a colonial rule. For every Indian in those times, it was indeed a Herculean task to fight against those powerful giants, the British. Those difficult times and struggles must not be allowed to fade away from our memories. We celebrate Independence Day every year on 15th of August to commemorate the independence of our country from United Kingdom on 15th of August 1947. Hence, every Independence Day, we not only celebrate our independence, but we also pay tribute to the ones who fought for it, to the ones who had a vision for it, and to the ones who sacrificed their life for the same. Many were there who freed us from the shackles of slavery. The idea of being an independent nation where the sovereign power lies in our hands to determine our future places a huge responsibility on our shoulders. The significance of its beautiful story where the sovereign power lies in our hands shows that this country had gained respect from all over the world for the democratic path chosen by it. We can proudly say that India had never invaded any of the countries in its past 10,000 years of history. On this occasion, our thoughts first turn to Mahatma Gandhi, the father of the nation and the man behind our freedom struggles, and the martyrs who commemorated, who sacrificed themselves for our country's liberty. There were several freedom fighters who sacrificed themselves for the altar of freedom. Some of them were Subhash Chandra Bose, Lala Lajpat Rai, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Bhagat Singh, Chandrasekhar Azad, Jawaharlal Nehru, and many more. We are also reminded of the relentless struggle of our great patriots who liberated our motherland from the colonial rule. Gandhiji was seeking liberty from both foreign rule and the indigenous social chains that had long incarcerated our society. We are also reminded of the relentless struggle of those patriots. Every other Indian was guided on a path of self-belief and hope for a better future. Democracy gives us a right to live in one and as a proud citizens of our country. Today, we are fortunate enough to live in one due to the vision of our freedom fighters and their sacrifice. There is a big celebration every year in New Delhi at Rajpath where the national anthem is sung after the Prime Minister hoists the flag. Also, a salute is given to the national flag by firing 21 guns with the national anthem, and flowers are showered via helicopter. All the forces take part in the parade. At the end, we cannot merely say that 15th August is solely about freedom. This day is a plethora of emotions. It reminds us of the pain of being enslaved, of the strength in unity. It defines sacrifice. It gives us a better example that some wars can be ended with non-violence and all the things. It makes us value and cherish our freedom that we have today. So, as a proud citizens of our country, we should take an oath together to carve a better future for our motherland. We should proud on ourselves and perform our duty and work for the growth and development of our country. No laws can separate us, no caste can divide us, no colors or creed can determine our future, because we are the children of one mother. At the last, but not the least, once again, I would like to wish you all a very happy Independence Day. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.